that now we are realizing that when it comes to warring, it is synonymous with Europe.
No, that's not true. See, no. even Africa.
Since the internet age,
okay,
I've seen several wars in Europe than I've seen in anywhere in the world.
Well, see, I will tell you. See, compared to the history of Europe, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, compared to the history of Europe,
Yes, yes.
Europe since the Second World War until last year, is it February? When Russia did whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Europe has been very, very calm. Yes.
That's not true, brother.
No, I said compared to their history.
No, Russia took Donbass. Yes. That was a war. When Russia was taking Donbass, it was a war.
Listen to my word. I say compared to their history.
Yes, okay.
That's God.
That's relatively
yes. compared to the history.
Yes, they are warmongers. Yeah, I get you.
I will tell you. I will say this today. Listen, my brother.
Yes.
If we're not forced, I want you to think about this.
Yes.
If we're not forced into a certain space and call it a country,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah.
A continent with 3,000 different tribes.
Yeah.
What do you think will happen to us today?
But are we saying that it's not the same in Europe?
No. See, that's what happened in Europe. In Europe.
Yes.
Okay. So the same thing would have happened to us.
See, the thing is this. Let's take Nigeria, for instance.
Yes.
The problem Nigeria is facing is that it is about four different huge ethnic groups.
Yes.
Joined together by...
By force.
Yes, by what? Lugard.
Yes.
Yes. So you have the Hausa. You have
Fulani.
You have the
Yoruba, Igbo.
And you have the Igbos.
Yeah.
These are all huge states that could have built their own.
Yes.
Right.
Okay. So let me tell you one thing. By the time the British were conquering from the south, do you know what will happen from the north?
Tell me.
The jihadists.
Yes.
Yeah.
Otto Fodio and his people.
Yeah. Okay. They were coming from north down.
Yes.
So see, this is the history of human beings.
Yes.
Okay. No matter where you think they are, this is the history of human beings.
Yes.
See, my
point here is before Uthman Danfodio and the likes.
Mm.
Would associate themselves with the foreigners.
Mm.
There were little of these things going on.
Okay,
I'm not going to lie that empires were not conquering empires because in the 25th dynasty of Egypt was ruled by the Nubians. Yeah, and they conquered. Egypt too. Egypt in turn also conquered Nubia.
Okay.
Yeah, where Ramesses II built all these monuments in the Aswan Cataract. So there was that thing. For instance, but my point here is it became like, I mean, when we associated ourselves with Islam and Christianity, because for instance, the fall of Nubia was as a result of King Izana embracing Christianity in Ethiopia in the 4th century.
Okay.
That is 338 thereabout AD, when Izana took hold of Ethiopia, the throne, and was coerced to invade Nubia, because then Nubia had not accepted Christianity.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
And after there are monuments that Ezana built after the conquest, built an obelisk that made an inscription on it on the conquest of Nubia.
Okay.
So and that was backed by the Christendom.
Okay. So the point is this.
Same goes with Uthman Danfodio.
Okay.
When he was backed by the Islamic Caliphate in Morocco to invade the Hausa kingdoms.
Okay.
You understand? So it was going on, but
This is it. This is what human beings do. See, the one reason that people need to understand. One, it was going on in Ashanti, in present day Ghana.
So in present day Ghana, we'll have the Dentra people. The Dentra people were the strongest. They were all accounts.
Yeah.
Dentras were a formidable force. They were, and they would control, they would take tribute from all these satellite states.
Okay.
So that's how the Ashanti kingdom came about.
Yeah.
That's how
they come about from wars.
So now the Dentras are dominating these smaller towns and taking tributes from them, capturing them as slaves and all that.
Okay.
So they decided, okay, we have to unite and form our own empire, because like a broom,
it's not big. Yeah.
So they decided and they unified against the common enemy, which are the Dentras, and they defeated the Dentra and assimilated them into their empire.
Okay. So let me say this to you. See, in human civilization, wars was the means of integration.
Yes, that's correct.
That's it.
That's correct.
Okay. Now, in Africa, people don't understand how big Africa is.
Very huge.
Good.
That's one thing.
See, because we are so dispersed.
Yes.
Okay, that's why we never encounter each other so often.
Yes.
Okay, if we're so packed together, like in Europe.
Yeah.
Okay.
Europe is so small.
If it was like in Europe, in Central Europe, would have been fighting as often as they were.
Yes, yeah, that's true. I agree.
But because we dispersed. When you're encountering each other,
we had vast land. So if you come and invade me, I move away and go to
and start
something over there.
Okay, and maybe that's how people were dispersed to other. They left the continent. Let me run away from these people.
Yes,
to Egypt. To across the Horn of Africa and so on, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
Anyway. So